Hello and welcome to the Salvation Army's annual carol concert at the Royal Albert Hall in London. People are just arriving for tonight's concert as we come together in Christmas celebration with the Salvation Army. We'll enjoy music from our international staff band led by Dr. Steve Cobb and international staff songsters led by Dorothy Nancekievill, so why not sing along at home? We'll also be welcoming to the stage special guests Rosemary Conley, Joanna Adeyinka-Burford, Dame Siân Phillips, The Idols, Caitlin Kisumba and family, and more. And I'll be backstage bringing you a glimpse from behind the scenes, as well as some familiar faces with messages of hope and encouragement.
Thank you. Good evening. I'm Colonel Paul Main, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to celebrating Christmas with the Salvation Army here at the Royal Albert Hall in London. We are in for a wonderful evening, and I extend a very special welcome to the hundreds of thousands of people around the world watching this carol service online. You'll find the details of all performers in your programme, a copy of which can be downloaded if you're watching from the comfort of your home. Tonight is an opportunity to celebrate. The past few years have been quite difficult, haven't they, for us? COVID pandemic, a war in Europe, a war now in the Middle East, and of course the cost of living crisis. And understandably, it can easily make us feel a little low. But for the next 90 minutes, I hope the joy of the Christmas message will lift your spirits. Christmas is a time of year when we remember and celebrate light conquering darkness, hope overcoming despair, all because of the birth of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. So if you're looking for good news, then Jesus is the best news ever. So I hope you're ready for an uplifting evening. As a Christian church, the Salvation Army wants that this carol service will be blessed by God. And so right at the commencement of our time together, I ask that you allow me to pray. Shall we pray? Our loving Heavenly Father, as we begin this evening celebrating the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, we are reminded of the words of the psalmist in Psalm 98, written more than 2,500 years ago, that says, "Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing, with trumpet and the blast of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord the King." Lord, that's what we want for this carol service here in the Royal Albert Hall. that our singing will be joyful because of your great love for all your people, that we will find hope despite the darkness of our time. So I pray that for all of us, that we will be filled with joy and hope and peace. In the name of Jesus, I make this prayer. Amen. Amen. Well, if you're able, I invite you to stand and sing with us the first carol of this service, O Come, All You Faithful. And from the rest of the evening, I invite you to follow the instructions on the screen. Let's stand together. Thank you.
Everyone, I hope you're having a wonderful evening at the Royal Albert Hall. A Merry Christmas and a very, very Happy New Year to everybody there. Thank you for coming out in force to support the work of the amazing Salvation Army, who were there all year round, not just at Christmas, to help the most vulnerable people in our society. Thank you for all that you do, and thank you for being there tonight to support them in their work. Have a great evening and lots of love from Julie Hesmondhalgh, maybe better known as Hayley in Coronation Street, amongst other things.
Good evening. The first reading is from Luke, from chapter 1, verses 26 to 38. In the 6th month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent Angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is in her 6th month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. I hope you're enjoying your evening so far. I certainly am. This reading is from Luke chapter 1, verse 39 to 56. At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill his promises to her." And Mary said, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. For he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him from generation to generation. He has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent away the rich empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised our ancestors." Mary stayed with Elizabeth for about 3 months and then returned home. This is the word of the Lord.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and my name is Ben Richards, and I would like to wish you all a very, very happy Christmas on this evening where we are celebrating the Salvation Army, an amazing group of people that basically make Christmas for me. I know growing up, hearing the sound of that band, I knew that Christmas was coming. And it's not just that, is it? It's what they do. And what they do is incredible on so many different fronts. And for some people, they are the difference between life and death. They are the last place they get to when there's no one to help. And they are there. They are always there. And I would personally like to wish them all a very, 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 very heartfelt thank you. And I hope a lot of money is raised tonight. I'm sorry I can't be there. I'm working here. But I wish you all a very, very happy Christmas. And thank you once again to the Salvation Army.
Luke 2:1-20. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Thank you. Rosemary Kelle Bryan from Maternal, Loose Women, and you also might know me as playing Martine on Hollyoaks. I just wanted to wish you all a fantastic Merry Christmas. I'm sorry I can't be with you all this evening. I am busy playing a fairy in Panto. Oh, no, she isn't. Oh, yes, she is. But on a serious note, I want to thank each and every volunteer for the Salvation Army. Out of 650 churches and community centres that you work in, helping victims of modern slavery, to helping people with community choirs and food banks, you provide a priceless lifeline and service to so many up and down the country. So I wish you all an amazing night. Don't stop giving. Take care. Bye.
Family tracing is a very special service that has been part of the Salvation Army since 1885. Requests were made to corps officers from families to help trace children and even adults that had gone missing. One of the mission priorities of the Salvation Army is to seek justice and reconciliation. And reconciliation is definitely the reason that the Family Tracing Service exists. Are there any other matters that you'd like to discuss? We have a team of three caseworkers and myself, and we do have some admin support from other colleagues that work at our headquarters. So each caseworker would hold a caseload of at least 200 cases on a rolling basis throughout a year. So that is no mean feat, and you know, to be able to deal graciously and sensitively with all parties concerned, you know, in a case. We do have a success rate of 89% of traces, and at this time it's about 30 families a month that we would be able to reunite. Lots of times we are at the seat of experiencing somebody's joy at that thought of being reconnected once again. And that's why I do this role.
Well, I'm delighted to welcome to the stage Billy, who is part of our family tracing team here in London. But Billy, you obviously haven't been working in family tracing for 140 years, but we're delighted that you're here and that you're part of the ministry that the Salvation Army has in bringing separated families together. What is the most rewarding part of your job?
Thank you, Paul. So obviously when families are reunited, sometimes after many years of being separated, it is so rewarding and beautiful to see how these renewed relationships develop. But I see the actual tracing process as a journey for the families that we help. And for me, the most rewarding thing is being there, particularly at the beginning, when someone decides to embark on this journey and to reach out to a family member in the hope of reconciliation.
So a real privilege, a beautiful ministry. And we're grateful that you're part of that, but it can't always be easy. What would you say is the greatest difficulty that you face?
So we will always respect the wishes of the person who we're looking for, and that means sometimes sharing maybe unwanted or unexpected news with the family member who's applied to our service. And so, you know, if we are able to contact someone we're looking to trace and they tell us that they don't want contact, that is of course respected. And sadly, sometimes if we find out news that shows that the person we're looking for has passed away, you know, that's the difficult job then to pass that information on.
So Christmas can be a challenging time for many people. What is your hope for the families that the Salvation Army has successfully reunited?
So for those with families, I hope that they treasure the relationships they have and the love and the joy that that brings. But in particular for families that maybe have just recently reunited, the reconciliation process is ongoing and it can sometimes be difficult. But again, with perseverance, these renewed relationships can bring love and joy to them.
Thank you.
Dear Family Tracing,
I've never heard him as excited as he was when he called me to say that you'd been in touch and found them.
I just want to say a big, massive thank you to you all.
We really appreciate the effort and work that you have done.
I cannot tell you how happy we are and what this means to us.
We will be forever grateful for all your hard work.
This wouldn't have been possible without you and all your efforts. Thank you so much.
It was such a relief for me to know that my sister is still alive.
Thank you. This is from me and my 91-year-old dad. You have reunited a family when literally time is limited.
And giving my granddad the opportunity to see his sister after all these years.
Take care, everyone, and keep up the good work. You're all amazing. With much appreciation, Michelle.
So thank you again for your help. Yours sincerely, Amrit.
Yours, Jackie.
Warm regards, Steve.
Billy, I want to say thank you to you and the family tracing team for all that you do to reunite families. It's incredible to think that for 140 years, the Salvation Army Family Tracing Service has managed to reunite tens of thousands of family members across the world. And I'm delighted this evening to say that some of those who have been reunited, those who have been reconciled, are with us in this auditorium this evening. So will you welcome them and thank Billy and the Salvation Army Family Tracing Team for their work and ministry. The families who've been reunited, God bless you.
Well, that was fantastic. Let's head backstage. So here we are, backstage, you're on after this. How are you feeling? Ready to perform at the Royal Albert Hall?
We're excited.
You've performed in some amazing places. How does this compare?
Well, I mean, it's so gorgeous when we perform together and in London, because it means family and friends can come, but also just because it's an amazing cause.
This space.
There's a lot of... They're all pros, basically.
We're thrilled that you've taken the time out of your busy schedules come and bless us with your beautiful music. Go and have a wonderful evening.
Thank you.
See you out there.
See you soon. See you out there.
Oh, bless the Lord, my soul. His praise to thee proclaim, and all that is within me joys to bless his holy name. Oh, yes. Oh, bless the Lord, my soul. His mercy bear in mind. Forget not all his benefits. The Lord to thee is kind.
That was awesome. I got to follow that. Bless the Lord, my soul. Thank you to the Idols and to the SA Big Band for delivering that message to us. I hope you got it. Bless the Lord, O my soul. I don't know if you caught all of that. And I need to just say something. Tonight is all about Jesus. And Christmas, crazy as it might seem for some of us, is all about Jesus. And tonight, as that message comes over, bless the Lord, O my soul, I hope it blesses you within your spirit. Now, I don't know whether you caught all of the words of that anthem from Godspell, but it says, Jesus pardons all thy sins. He prolongs thy feeble breath. He heals thine infirmities, and he ransoms thee from death. He clothes thee with love, and he upholds thee with truth. Then bless his holy name, whose grace has made thee whole, whose love and kindness crowns thy days. Awesome. Overwhelmingly awesome. Last week, I was flicking through YouTube, and I came across a clip of Michael McIntyre and Rosalind Pike in conversation. And they were puzzling over the fact that you could know what it is to be overwhelmed and even have an experience of being underwhelmed, but who, asks Michael McIntyre, has ever simply been whelmed? It's quite a thought. And I hope none of you are just whelmed, and I hope none of you are underwhelmed. I've got to say to you, it is an overwhelming experience for me to speak again from this platform. Overwhelming because of what we're hearing and experiencing, but also overwhelming because nearly 40 years ago, Jill and I, my wife, with others, stood on the spot just near those Christmas trees, and we were commissioned and we were ordained as Salvation Army officers. It's quite a thing for me to come back to the place where my officership began. And if that's not enough to overwhelm me, it's overwhelming because 111 years ago, William Booth, the founder of the Salvation Army, gave his last public address from this same platform, probably on this very spot, declaring, while women weep as they do now, I'll fight. While children go hungry as they do now, I'll fight. While men go into prison, in and out, as they do now, I'll fight. Where there's a poor lost girl upon the streets, while there remains one dark soul without the light of God, I'll fight to the very end, said William Booth. And so it's an overwhelming privilege to say a few words to explain that while we are all called to join in that fight that William Booth referenced, it was and it is a battle in the context of embracing the mission of whose birth we celebrate tonight, Jesus himself. In a much smaller, simpler, intimate venue than this, Jesus declared in a Nazareth synagogue, he said this, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free and to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. Bless the Lord, O my soul." This is God on the move. In fact, when it comes to considering Jesus, as surely we must, heading towards Christmas, this is God making himself unmistakably and uniquely known to the world. In a strange kind of way, I think it could be argued that Jesus was the original selfie. Of course, not a picture on a mobile, but the reality, the authenticity of the nature and the person of God delivered for us. In fact, St. Paul, in one of his New Testament letters, Colossians, he nails it when he said that Jesus is the image of the invisible God, a selfie delivered, not to see how many likes he might get on social media, but self-given and ultimately self-sacrificed to demonstrate his total love for us, for the world. And that includes every one of us. This is overwhelmingly good, joyful news. When the angel pitched up to the shepherds, they were terrified. But the angel said to them, don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. And there is again an overwhelming sense of joy much later when those wise men, having been to Jerusalem, were nearing Bethlehem. Matthew explains that the star that they had seen went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they were overjoyed. Not underjoyed, not even joyed. No, they were overjoyed. They were overwhelmed with the prospect of being in the presence of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, the one known as the Messiah, the Lord, the one called Emmanuel, meaning God is with us. That experience of comfort and joy because of the presence of Jesus is what tonight is all about. And it is our hope and our prayer that for you and yours, this Advent and Christmas tide, you'll know the overwhelming joy that comes from his presence, from his very self, by his Spirit among us. And may that be especially true for you tonight, if you're having to face great sadness, difficulties, darkness. May God bless you with comfort, and may Jesus make your joy complete. Well, what better carol for us to now stand and sing than Joy to the World, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing. May that be so for all of us, and may God bless you with a very joyful Christmas. God bless you.
Hey guys, Richard Blackwood here in my dressing room at Hollyoaks. But I want to say a huge congratulations to the Salvation Army. You guys help people that are less fortunate than ourselves in all different types of situations, things that are so horrific, but you guys step out, you're in the front lines, making sure that you can do the best that you can to help the unfortunate out there. So I hope tonight goes very well for you all and they celebrate you in true style and fashion. If I was there, it'd be done proper, but you know, I couldn't make it, but I'm just saying, it's in good hands. Guys, well done to you. Keep doing what you do, because we need you on the front lines. God bless.
Thank you. Everybody.
Yes, Merry Christmas from your idols.
Shall we sing them a little jingle bells?
Yes. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Over fields we go, laughing all the way.
Bells on bobtail ring, making spirit bright. What fun it is to ride and sing our favorite song tonight.
Jingle bells, yeah, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, ja ja ja, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what a lot of fun, what a lot of fun to ride and sing in a one-horse open sleigh.
Dashing through the snow,
we are dashing
in a one-horse open sleigh.
One-horse sleigh.
Over fields we go,
over the fields we go, we go.
Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright.
What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a
one-horse open sleigh.
Everybody, it's Toyah Willcox here. Firstly, wishing you all a wonderful Christmas. Enjoy the Salvation Army's beautiful Christmas concert. And I would like to say thank you to the Salvation Army for bringing music into communities, for helping those in times of poverty and hardship, helping make people feel they belong, welcoming people into communities. Your work is so incredibly important and valued. And thank you. Happy Christmas to all of you. Lots of love, Toyah.
nervous?
Good, yeah, no, we're excited.
Your family's been amazing all evening. We can't wait to hear the finale. Oh, it's going to be wonderful.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Go and enjoy.
Thank you.
Mark, we're ready.
All ready for you.
A word from you can set it back on fire. And if I should ever fall, I know you'll catch me if I only call. You fill my cup and it overflows. Your love lifts me up high. Your love lifts me up. Your love lifts me up. Not far will go.
Your love lifts me up, your love lifts me up.
What an incredible evening. I hope you have really enjoyed your time in this carol service. Shall we do it again? Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Colonel Paul Main, and I welcome you. But what a great occasion we've had. I hope you leave this evening full of the spirit of Christmas. We've got a lot of thank yous to say, so hold your applause till the end, and then there'll be a raucous of applause as we say thank you to those who have played an important part in our carol service. The incredible musical Kisumba family that we've just experienced, the love that lifts us up through Jesus Christ, we thank him for that. The idols, our celebrity readers, Rosemary Conley, remember to get your video out when you go home. Joanna Burford, Siân Phillips, our organist, Paul Leddington Wright, Billy Harrington-Roberts from the Family Tracing Service, the Salvation Army Big Band, the International Staff Band of the Salvation Army, and the International Staff Songsters of the Salvation Army. Now's your chance to applaud. Obviously, we couldn't celebrate Christmas here in the Royal Albert Hall without you, and you've been a wonderful audience. You've been the best audience we've ever had. So please come back next year to prove that you're still the best audience we've ever had. Thank you. Thank you for your support. Thank you for joining with us here this evening. Before we sing our final carol, I have one request. And you know what's coming. Your ticket price ensured that we would cover the costs of this wonderful evening. But if you'd like to give anything else that will go directly to the work of the Salvation Army in the United Kingdom and in Ireland, we have buckets for your cash. We have card readers for your credit card or your debit card. Just think, following a wonderful evening, you can pay it forward through your donation tonight by helping spread the Christmas joy to many, many, many more people. Thank you for your generosity, and thank you for your support. Now let's stand and sing our final carol, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, Glory to the Newborn King.
Thank you.
Well, good night, and God bless you, and a very happy Christmas to each one of you. Good night.